What are your thoughts on gay men who don't like Beyoncé? Welcome to the Logo Spill Bar, where the drinks are strong, the tea is hot, and the guests are... I'm your bartender and host, Johnny Sibilly, and today's guest is that viral bitch. Actor, model, and the content creator, his 7 million followers devour his hot, hilarious takes on the daily. Social media does not exist without this king. Please welcome Rickey Thompson.
Hello, darling.
Wow.
Hey.
Woo, struck.
Like it?
Hit it. Hit it.
Damn. I look delicious to you.
You do.
Wow.
Gorgeous.
Hey.
Welcome to the Spill Bar.
Let me grab my drink real quick.
A little sippy shim. Well, I'm so happy you're here. I've got a lot to talk about with you.
Oh, yes.
First of all, I just have to say, you bring me so much joy.
Oh my gosh, stop.
You bring a lot of people joy, but this is about me right now because it's my show.
Okay, yeah.
I have giggled at you for so long with you. I have a folder that has your videos. You keep me well alive in a group chat.
You have a folder of me?
Well, not just of you.
Oh, you know, well, okay.
Icons like you, Nene Leakes, Abby Lee Miller from Dance Moms.
Okay, period. You know. I'm in with the group.
Yeah,
I like that.
All right, so before we get into all of the other things that you do, I need to know what it was like working with Rihanna for her Savage X Fenty show, Volume 4.
Oh my gosh. First of all, love Rihanna down. Like, when I got that call, I said, wait a minute, Rihanna wants me to walk? Like, period. It was amazing. You know, I got to see my outfit. It was perfect. Yeah. And yeah, I went on there. I did it in one take.
One take.
She was like, it's amazing. It's everything. He ate that. Let's move on. I said,
so she was watching you do it?
Yes, from her trailer.
Did you feel like, oh, I ate that in one shot? Or were you like, I wish I would have gotten another take?
Oh, I want another take so bad. But I wanted one so bad. I was like, oh my gosh, really? It's like, she really likes it. I was like, okay, if she likes it, I guess
yeah,
I ate. But watching it back, I was like, oh, I actually ate it up.
You did.
So yeah.
You did eat it
Thank
up.
Thank you.
Can you please educate the children
okay.
at home? Give them the 411 of your Vine origin story.
Oh, you're taking it all the way back to Vine
now.
Oh my goodness. Well, hello.
Hey, it's me, Rickey T. Y'all, this lighting right now, though. Now, where are those haters?
Haters?
Are you here, haters?
Haters, where are you? Rickey has a cold drink for you.
I started Vine 2013. Mm. 2013, I was like a junior in high school. I was so bullied down, like bullied down. Like no one liked me, thought I was a loser or whatever. But you know, when I became poppin', you know, I became that girl,
yeah,
okay?
Yeah.
So like, you know, I was in high school just talking about relationships, family, all that type of stuff. And then my video started going viral. And then one day, Kylie Jenner reminded me. Yeah. And I was like, oh, the girls were sick. They're like, oh, wow. Because, you know, King Kylie in that era, like, you know.
Yeah, she was.
She was that girl.
Yeah.
So I got reminded by her, and, like, the rest is, like, history. Like, I was, like, an underdog in high school, and then I won prom king. So.
Look at that. We love, a coming out on top.
You know, right?
How did you, were there ever people that, like, didn't realize that they had done that to you in the past?
Oh, have they came back and said something? Oh, yes, they have.
Yeah.
Like, oh, my God, like, you were in my, like, grade or whatever. I'm like, yeah, you used to bully me, like, real bad. Mm-hmm. No, I didn't do that. Yeah, you did.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, oh, I'm so sorry. Like, you're so successful. And I'm like, thank you.
And
Next.
Am.
Thank
yeah.
you. And am. Thank you. Yes.
Did you ever kiki with Kylie?
Oh, girl, of course. Okay, so when she did it, maybe I graduated high school a year after that.
Mm.
And then I moved to L.A. And the first party I went to in L.A., I met her.
Wow.
Isn't that crazy?
What was this party?
Okay, there was this thing in L.A. called, like, Pink Tank. It was, like, the party. Like, every celebrity would go. Mm. It was, like, a house in the hills or whatever. And I remember she got there, and I was like, oh, my God, that's Kylie. My friend's like, you gonna speak? Like, she knows you. I was like, no. And I remember I got and I was walking down the driveway, and this black car pulls up next to me. The window comes. I was like, oh, my God, Rickey, I love you. I said, Kylie. Yes, she put me on her Snapchat. I'll never forget that. Yeah. Wow. Mm-hmm.
You must have felt so fab.
Oh my gosh. Everyone's like, oh my God, like you're on Kylie's story. I was like, yeah.
How is that when you come straight from high school to LA, where people just like, oh my God, it's you. You're here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They're like, oh my gosh, like you're not on the phone screen. You're actually here. I'm like, yeah.
Yeah. And I am.
And I am. Thank you.
Book me.
Come on. Yes.
So your Vine moment was 2013,
yes.
But here we are 11 years later. Crazy.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, 11 years.
Now you have millions upon millions
of
thirsty followers, brand deals, acting gigs, Forbes 30 under 30, and even a prime spot here at the Spill Bar on season 3.
Hey.
I'd say the bitch has made it. Being someone that lives for you.
Okay, yes.
And your nonstop energetic contact, I need to know, do you get tired?
I'm going to say, yes, I do. Because I feel like, you know, a lot of times people just want to be on all the time. And, like, a lot of people know this, I'm a very shy person. Mm-hmm. I am. Like, literally, if I'm not, like, in front of a camera or whatever, I get so nervous, like, meeting somebody new.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I mean, am I shy towards you a little bit?
No.
Okay, period.
But, I mean, I think that's the thing. When we're alone and we're doing, like, these things, it's one thing. But when you're meeting new people, you're still having this human interaction.
Literally, I don't want to yell at you, like, hey, bitch! Like, I don't want to do that. You know what I mean? Scare you off.
Yeah. I had one, someone tell me once, they're like, you're so much funnier online. I'm like, what do you want? I'm not going to be like,
yeah, for real, exactly. You're just trying to be cool,
So this shy Rickey Thompson,
mm-hmm.
please tell us about her.
Yes.
When you're feeling shy, what do you go to?
My phone. Like, literally, I am painfully shy.
Yeah.
I feel like it's something I'm still trying to work on. Mm. Like, I cannot go into a room by myself.
Yeah.
I need at least someone there that I know, like my safety blanket or whatever.
Yeah, when they invite you and they're like, no, plus one.
I'm like, ooh, child. I'm like, yes, I won't be there. I can't do it. I wish I could get past it, but anxiety is so scary.
Well, what's the difference between that and, like, affirming yourself in that moment? Because I do the same thing. I'm like, don't pick up your phone.
Mm-hmm.
Don't pick up your phone. And I feel like sometimes, like, I just push through it. Do you ever, like...
No. I never push through it. Like, if I don't know anyone, like, at a party or anything, you would see me in the corner scrolling through TikTok, you know, Instagram. Then I'll go to the calculator, start tapping in numbers. Honestly, truly, I just don't like feeling alone. Yeah. It's really a scary feeling.
What if someone that you didn't know came up and was like, hey, how are you?
I still... I can't do it. So I'm like, girl, you don't know me. Like, we're not close like that.
Right. Okay, in a Vogue interview.
Okay.
A Vogue interview.
Oh, just
so all y'all heard that.
I have multiple.
Okay. In 2021, you said, I look at myself every day in the mirror and I say, oh my gosh, you're beautiful, you're black, keep it pushing.
Mm-hmm.
Are you still an affirmation queen?
I am.
Yeah.
Honestly, I feel like if I didn't do that, I wouldn't be where I am today. Like, I'm obsessed with myself. I think it's, like, an actual problem. Like, I don't know what it is. Like, I look at myself, I'm like, wow, bitch.
Yeah.
You're you.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
I'm
I love
one of
it.
One.
Yes, I'm one of one. I'm the only one, darling.
Do you feel like you sharing that to the world was part of you reminding yourself of that and also be like, hey, you too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because I definitely, like, with my content, I definitely want people to relate with me, like, on that type of level. Because, you know, hey, like, I used to be low. I used to not have confidence. And by me saying that every day for years, I finally feel it. Like, I'm that bitch. Like,
say that into the camera.
I am that bitch. Thank you.
Is there anyone that you've met that you were like, oh, wow, I thought I would be more, like, starstruck?
Honestly, truly, when I met Beyonce.
Me too!
Yeah, you know!
I was like, oh, she's so, like...
Like, she's so
chill.
Cool and chill and just so sweet. And I thought, because I've been a fan of Beyonce, like, since... No. You know what I mean? Like, I've been there. You know? Like, come on. Like, I've been there. So when I met her, I was like... I didn't cry.
Yeah.
I was like normal.
She's got very like calming energy around
her. Very calming.
Yeah. But when she's on stage,
I was giving. Would you ever like freak out like in front of her? I would kind of be embarrassed.
I would be embarrassed too.
Yeah.
I think that's probably why, because it's like
security.
I love you so much.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna f*** this up. Yeah. In the past, you said you keep relationships private.
Mm-hmm.
Clink, clink.
Yes.
Is that still true?
It is true. Mm. I feel like, you know, once you publicly say that you're dating somebody, that's when all shit just hits the fan.
Right.
Keep it to yourself until you get a ring on your finger. Or honestly, ooh, I would hate for you to embarrass me after we're married. Oh, gosh. Keep it a secret for the rest of your life. Yeah. Period. Yes. Mm-hmm.
You stay home.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. How would you feel about being like the Taylor Swift to someone's Travis Kelce?
Oh my God, I'll be so happy. Oh my God. I want a football player so bad. Like, I just want an athlete, period. Mm. Most likely soccer, though.
Oh.
Yes, from Madrid. Ooh.
Okay. Yes. We love that. Okay, we have to talk about We Said What We Said.
Yes.
You co-host a podcast with your longtime best friend, Denzel Dion. As someone who also hosts a podcast with their besties, it can be a little chaotic.
Yes.
What's the messiest convo you've ever had on the pod?
The messiest convo. I will say there was like a particular rendezvous that went down in Paris that Denzel did not like me talking about. And I was like, sorry, girl. But I thought it'd be a funny story. But we had to cut that shit out.
You're like, so good for the pod. It's good for the pod.
Good for the pod. You know, we do it for the plot. Honestly, truly, you know, I do things for the plot. That I'm that type of person. But he was like, girl, too much. Too much. I was like, sorry.
So, yeah, that's the thing. Being with your best friend, but this is like a space where, like, you're not alone.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's listening.
Exactly.
Has that ever jeopardized the closeness that you have? Like, do y'all tussle?
All the time. Mm. Like, you know, we fight like brothers, which is, like, amazing. Because I feel like, you know, are you guys really best friends if you guys have never fought and like that? You know? Yeah. Like, we step on each other's toes sometimes, but that's my dude for my life, whatever. Love him down. Yeah. But yeah, it's good to a little argue.
It's fun to watch and listen. You feel like you're in someone's living room, like, oh, they're going at it.
Literally.
But you don't have to be involved. You know when people fight in front of you and you're like in the space and you're like, what am I doing?
I'm like, oh, I love that. I love you. I'm like, wow, you said that. That's right.
Ooh. You're like, oh,
wow. Oh. I'm like, that happened? Like, I get into it, girl. Yes.
Your podcast is overflowing with pop culture tea, and I live for your takes, as you know.
Yeah.
So here are some pop culture topics I need your take on.
Okay.
Drag Race.
Love it. I love Drag Race. I love it. Simone, hey, sister, if you're watching,
I love Simone.
That's my girl. Then it causes twins. I see it.
Cults.
Like, you mean it's a regular cult? Like Charles Manson and shit? Oh.
Or like CrossFit. That's a cult.
Oh. Ooh, fine. I know. That's a fine cult. Ooh, I'm not a fan. I mean, if it's a good cult, maybe.
Right.
But if it's like, you know.
If it's chic.
If it's chic, yes, a chic cult.
What are your thoughts on Geminis?
Girl.
What did a Gemini do to you?
I've had two ex-best friend Geminis.
Oh.
Yeah. It's just like the whole, like, it's the honesty for me. Like, I don't like somebody who's brutally honest.
Oh.
Yeah, I can't do that. Mm-hmm. Like, I'd rather be nice, nasty a little bit, but not brutal.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Gay men who don't like Beyonce.
Ugh. I can't stand them. Like, honestly, truly. Like, for real. Like, what's wrong with Beyonce?
Right.
Like, name one wrong thing.
Yeah.
Like, come on.
I can't.
You can't. Exactly. What? Are they trying to do that trying to get some attention?
That's what
it's
like.
It's not cute.
It's like, make your personality something else.
Literally, hating on Beyonce? Mm-hmm. Like, ooh. Mm-hmm.
The Real Housewives.
Yes, love. Down.
Favorite?
My favorite housewife, like all-time favorite, of course, would be NeNe. Come on. Because she said what she said, darling. Yes.
That girl. Uber driver's talking to you.
Oh, don't. Please don't. Headphones are on. I can't stand the people like the Uber drivers like try to talk to you with the headphones on.
Mm.
Hey, hey, you see me. Thank you. Keep driving. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
Poppers.
Oh, can we really get into this? So, okay, at first, I really wasn't into poppers. Then I dated this guy, and he was like, you know, because, like, you know, I like the position that I play, you know. I didn't realize that you could actually use stuff to get it there. Girl, that's my first thing I said. Oh, okay. Yeah. Fun times, fun times. Yeah.
Okay, we love poppers.
Yeah, we love poppers.
Sponsor us. What is next for you? Tell me, because I feel like you do a little bit of everything. Mm. What is one thing that you have not done that you're like, I'm on my way?
I definitely want to act more. Mm. Like, I definitely want to do that. I was on Swarm, which I loved it.
Yes, my guest appearance.
You know what I mean? It was cute and fab. But, like, now I'm ready for, like, a recurring role on a show that lasts for Grey's Anatomy time. What? That's what, yes.
That's a check.
Yes, a check, yes. Girl, a check, yes. Yes, that's what I want, yes. Period, yes.
We got into it.
We did.
Maybe let's go get some mozzarella sticks or something.
I'm allergic to dairy. I'll keep drinking, though.
Okay.